we can have success in a sense, I guess, in two ways. So you can have success from a purely academic perspective, and then success in terms of what we as the Cave Hill campus would want in terms of the type of graduate we would create at the end of the day. And so from a purely academic point of view, I think coming into the law faculty in particular, a key element will be time management. There's a whole lot that goes on campus, maybe less so right now because of the restrictions related to COVID-19, but still there's a lot that's going on and you have a lot of classes. It's a higher level of responsibility to what you would be accustomed to at secondary school. And so it's really important that from the very beginning you get on top of organizing yourself and managing your time so you have an appropriate balance. Sort of related to that as well is making sure you go to tutorials. And I know I've seen some of the other videos and students spoke about that, and that's really critical. Tutorials are an important part of the learning process, certainly here in the law faculty. It's your opportunity as a student to demonstrate what you know, but also to understand what you don't know. Because sometimes you may have read a piece, etc., and you think you understand it, then you get into the classroom and then you realize, oh my goodness, no, I totally misunderstood. But because you prepared, because you sat down, you spent that time to think about the situation beforehand, it means then you're able to pinpoint to the tutor, to the course director, well, you know, I understood it in this way, and they can then explain to you how maybe you went about it wrong. If, however, you come unprepared, so it's not just about attending the tutorial, it's also about coming to the tutorial prepared. The other thing that I will say in terms of sort of managing that transition from secondary to university is we really try to instill in you from the get-go that you need to be a critical thinker. So you don't want to just be reading for regurgitation. You want to be trying to think deeply about what it is you're reading, what are the connections between different areas. You don't want to just be reading for a test or cramming for the exam. You really want to be spending the time to assimilate the knowledge. And as I said, to really understand the interlinkages, because in many of the areas, certainly in law, their commonalities, and so you want to, those interlinkages are important. Sort of linked to that, I'm a big person on not just learning in the classroom. So I find a lot of students, maybe because of the emphasis on exams and tests in the secondary school environment, only are interested in learning if there's a mark attached or if it is that it's coming, this topic is going to come for the exam. And what I have certainly found in terms of the students who have excelled and really done well, yes, they're bright, but I mean, once persons come into our faculty, they're going to be of a certain academic ability. But really what tends to distinguish those students that really go on to do outstandingly well is the students who spend the time to read outside of the area, who don't just study what is necessary to pass the test. The students who, you know, I have students who I'm still in contact with today who would have done extracurricular activities, who would have, you know, joined me on study visits to the UN, to UN Women, or to, you know, partake in the model United Nations that is run by the Rotary just as observers. And those aren't things that I give marks for in my class, but they've really benefited and grown from those opportunities. And it really helps them understand the linkages between what you're studying in the classroom and real life.